Brad Binder takes fourth place from Tom Lutie. That's an even bigger swing of the pendulum in this championship battle.
Fedeli, maybe he was saving his tyre again. He's really stretching Mattia Pazzini here. He's asking all sorts of questions of the experienced Italian. What have you got, Maestro? For the words that he is saying to his older friend.
Oh, Pazzini. Absolutely all over the rear tyre of Tom Lutie. Lutie is going to do a fantastic job to hang on to this fourth place.
Two battles are going on in the race here that could be so crucial to what you're looking at in the bottom right corner. Oh, and here comes Pazzini. He's made his move back up on the inside. He pulled that off earlier. He's done it again now. Will Morbidelli retaliate? He can't now. Michael Bartolomei won't be able to watch here the final lap and a half of this race.
No. Michael Bartolomei's got to go to the clinic with Alex Marquez just to get to some new fingernails, I think. Will Morbidelli...
No, he's unbelievable.
How did he do that? He came from way back on the brakes down to reverse corkscrew. Steve, this is what Miguel Oliveira needs. He needs these two. Pazzini again, a big, big moment. He squeezed on the power coming down through turn number 10.
Crucial lap and a half coming up. Oliveira, is he close enough? His ears are pricking up. He's just over a second down. He's managed to find 3/10 though, courtesy of the exchanges that just went on.
9/10. It's come down to Tom Lutie. He's found 2/10 as well. He's now almost 4/10 clear of Binder.
Pazzini now will be desperate, Matt. Desperate to try and get into the toe of Franco Morbidelli on this back straight. So will Oliveira. Morbidelli won't give this up.
Pazzini again, he has a moment. Pazzini is working so, so hard. Pete Benson, Morbidelli's crew chief, and Michael Bartolomei look on. They can barely watch the screen. The tension is really being ramped up here in Aragon, not only in terms of this Grand Prix, but in terms of the World Championship battle.
Can Oliveira catch? It doesn't look likely. Morbidelli here found something in the final sector. We're about to start the final lap of an intriguing encounter here in Aragon. The championship leader, Franco Morbidelli, leads, but not by much. Just a tenth between him and Pazzini, who decides not to pounce into turn one.
Well, that was the first big opportunity, wasn't it? I thought Pazzini had carried great momentum through those final two quarters. A line up and move on the brakes at turn number one. We saw him last time around, though, have an attack on Morbidelli coming through turns four and five. This left-hander complex, is he going for it again? Ubelli is. Pazzini then leads.
Oh, he's done it brilliantly, but here comes Morbidelli again. No, door closed. Now, will Morbidelli do what he did on the last lap? Will he go for that audacious lunge? It's the last lap of the race. Oliveira is praying that these two continue at this, just to have some sort of sniff at it.
Through seven, Pazzini leads. Down, they drop into the reverse corkscrew. Pazzini runs that tighter defensive line. He's not letting Morbidelli mug him this time around. Pazzini then just by Morbidelli.
Oh! High
touch. That's super aggressive by Morbidelli, and he found the way through somehow.
No matter what happens here, Franco Morbidelli has thrown the piece of paper Bartolomei gave him away. He is going for glory. Pazzini will fight back as well. Oliveira gets closer and closer in third place. Pazzini can't get it done there. Surely, Matt, it's all going to be down to the drive that Pazzini gets onto the back straight.
How late on the brakes of Franco Morbidelli down into turn number 12. Through 13 they come for the final time. Drop down the hill into turn number 14. Pazzini still not close enough. He's got to get crucial drive to try and slip through Franco Morbidelli down this back straight. Is he going to be close enough? The Italian Trench Racing team look on anxiously. Morbidelli's got five or six bike lengths. Two corners to go. Morbidelli looks like he might have this one covered.
Barring any mistakes, Franco Morbidelli can have the win of the season in his back pocket, and I don't think that Pazzini's close enough, barring a mistake here from Morbidelli. The checkered flag is waiting. It's not going to be enough. Franco Morbidelli just throws it all out. Brilliant stuff, and a win that could see him eventually crowned champion. He's done it again, against all odds. He sticks two fingers up.